Now let's go over how to work with the photos inside of your book. Each photo cell allows you to zoom the photo in or zoom it all the way out. When it's at 0%, you are seeing the entire image, so it's just fitting that vertical or horizontal image inside of whatever size container that you have. You can also right-click an image cell. If you don't want that photo to be zoomed in all the way into that cell, uncheck that option at the top. If you'd like to apply a setting such as this to all of your photos, then you need to select all of those photos first. Doing a Command All, that only selects the pages. It doesn't actually select the photos. Instead, go to Edit, Select All Photo Cells. Then, right-click over your photo and choose that same option, Zoom Photos to Fit Cell. Now all of those photos in your book are changed. Adding or changing the photo on a page is as simple as dragging and dropping. Choose the photo you'd like to use, and then drag it over the page. And if you'd like to add several photos at once, highlight them in the film strip, and then drag and drop them over the appropriate page, and they'll fill as many cells as photos you had selected. In this case, I didn't have enough photos to fit all of those cells, so I'd need to pick a few more if I wanted to complete that. You can also change how the photos look inside of a page. If you go into that cell panel on the right and then click on a photo, you have the option to set the padding. And padding is just space around the photo. By default, all of those are linked. If I unlink them, then I can alter the way that this photo appears on the image. I'll change this so that it fits the cell so you can see how this is working. Another thing you want to do when placing photos is you really want to watch those guidelines, those thin gray lines that are in your photo. I'm going to change this page to a two-page spread. That's a good one to work with. These gray lines on the outside is where my photo is going to very likely be cut off. This is important because when I'm moving the photo around the frame, I want to make sure that the area I want to be visible is inside of that gray line. If I had it all the way down here, for example, and I wanted this white portion to still show, it might end up getting cut off when it's printed. So you just want to make sure that the important parts of your photo are set inside of that area.